know, Karen was all of 20, and I was 23, and this was pretty heady stuff, especially in how quickly it all happened.
Although Close to You went to number one in the American charts and rapidly sold 1 million copies, Richard and Karen feared they wouldn't be able to build on its success.
It crossed our minds that maybe it's just one hit.
The answer to their prayers came from an unexpected source.
We've only just begun had all the romantic beginnings of a bank commercial. We sat down, we wrote the first two verses, showed the young couple getting married, driving off into the sunset.
This ad got a lot of play, and no more than the second time I heard it, it really caught my ear.
So many roads to choose. We start out walking.
Probably as close to greeting card lyrics as any hit I've ever written.
Yes, we're just begun.
It's not exactly Keats, you know.
You've got a long way to go. We'd like to help you get there.
I'm thinking this song could be a hit.
I was amazed, first of all, the difference between our very simple little recording for the commercial and what Richard had done. It was gorgeous.
If anything, I think that one has become our signature song.
And when the evening comes, we smile.
Confounding their critics, the Close to You album sold 5 million copies, and they dominated the American Music Awards.
For best contemporary vocal performance by a duo, the winner is
Carpenter's Close to You.
And I wasn't even thinking Grammys. The word comes out, you've been nominated 7 Grammys. You're nominated for. My goodness gracious.
Watching the signs along the way.
By the end of 1970, the Carpenters had conquered America and were setting their sights on worldwide success. Great fame and great wealth lay within their grasp. But it would come at a high price.
Together.
A major strength of the Carpenters' music was Karen's vocal, instantly recognizable as one of the great voices.
Talking to myself and feeling old.
Everything she sang, she touched with something very special inside her. Singing isn't just about getting the notes out. And she had something very special happening that I don't have.
Nothing to do but frown. Rainy days and Mondays on. Get me down.
The one talent that Karen resisted oddly, that she had naturally, was performing. Getting her out from behind the drums was a pain.
Nothing is really wrong. Feeling like I don't belong.
In the early days on the road, she did all the drumming and the singing. She did it from the set, same time. Remarkable facility and remarkable concentration.
Rainy days and Mondays always get me.
There's something much more cool about Karen Carpenter sat behind a kit singing than there is many other people. She's the best singing drummer ever.
But the greatness of her voice would increasingly pressurize her to reluctantly take the spotlight.
Funny, but it seems that it's the only thing to do.
More and more people were coming to see us. We were going from, say, 1,500 to 3,000 to 5,000. It was getting bigger and bigger. Karen was 5'4". I knew that the audience couldn't see a whole lot. I figured I should have a talk with her.
No need to talk it out. We know what it's all about.
It was difficult for her to leave the drums. She really enjoyed drumming. It was part of her persona.
Rainy days, Mondays always get me down.
Anybody who's ever played an instrument, myself included, will tell you that if you grew up performing with an instrument in front of you and then they take it away, you feel absolutely naked. It's awful.
Of course, it didn't go over too well. So we struck a deal for the ballads. she would get up and front the group.
Funny, but it seems that it's the only thing to do.
She suddenly felt very naked and very vulnerable, and instead of being a drummer who sang a bit, she became a singer who used to play the drums, and I think that's a fairly different state of mind.
Feels come and gone before. No need to tell.
I don't think she was a publicity seeker in any way at all, and to have the spotlight upon her was something that she did not particularly relish at the beginning.
We were back in the room together, and it came time for her to go out in front again. And she said, I gotta go out and face the wolves again. And immediately she put on the face and came out and did it.
Long ago, and oh so far away, I fell in love with you. Before the second show.
Karen's voice always reminded me of smoking wood. Some wood smells so wonderful. And that's what her voice reminded me of.
One of the best voices, female voices, of probably of all time.
But you're not really here. It's just the radio.
She sang a lyric, she sang it with such complete conviction, and she hit every note beautifully.
I love you, I really do.
Karen was now the focal point, but Richard remained the unsung production genius behind the Carpenters' success.
Because Karen was the voice, Richard tends to be in the shadows to a certain extent. But it was Richard's idea. Karen would not have been able to do this if Richard had not been pulling her strings.
He knew exactly how to produce Karen's vocals. And he was a master at choosing the keys, the songs, the message, the way she should sound.
After long enough of being alone, everyone must face their share of loneliness. In my own time, nobody knew the pain.
Karen had the perfect voice, and Richard made sure that everything was perfect around her, and that was really part of the secret of their magic, I think.
Was all I had until you came.
Richard was the chief architect, and no one should ever make a mistake about that. And Karen and I would have been the first to tell you that.
Richard still holds the record for producing the most top 10 singles in a row without missing. Not even the Beatles did this. Not even Elvis did this.
They were the biggest selling act for a period, even selling more records than Elvis. So that's the sort of scale you're looking at.
Baby, baby, feels like baby, things will be alright.
Against the backdrop of Vietnam and the soundtrack of psychedelic rock, the Carpenters were definitely out of step. They were branded square, middle class, preppy and safe. Parents liked them and the president loved them.
You showed me the way to leave the past and all its tears behind me. Tomorrow may be even brighter than today.
They're young America at its very best, and we think that tonight, having the Carpenters, one of America's finest young group in America, entertain us is most appropriate.
It was right in the middle of the Watergate scandal with Nixon while he was denying any knowledge of anything going on. So the tension was as thick as, you could cut it with a knife in that place.
Being invited to the White House to perform is not only a thrill, but it's indeed an honor.